is Casey Campbell with G1NBC Sports. We're down here at the Chevrolet Detroit Belle Isle Grand Prix presented by Lear, and we're in front of the Trans Am Series Garage. They're on the track right now, if you can see. Trans Am cars, they have got 28 cars at the event this week, 9 in TA and TA2 class as well. You can see the Trans Am Series is known as the American Muscle Series. The Trans Am cars have these V8 engines in them, but they're like your normal everyday cars. They can run really, really fast down the straightaway right here. We just saw one of the cars come in and crash. Here's an example of a TA car right here. Notice it's like your everyday car. It's got the engine in it. It's like the normal body of your car, but they put these V8 engines in them to make them go pretty fast, so it should be good. Of course, that's the background noise behind me. And that of course is the Trans Am cars. They're on the track right now. A busy day here at the Detroit Grand Prix. And just exciting, and we'll see if we can talk to some drivers as we go along. This is Casey Campbell with G1NBC with a number of reports. The first signing off for a number of reports here at the Grand Prix. Watch out there, Tommy Dreese's gonna run you over, man. This is Casey Campbell with G1NBC Sports. We're down here at the Chevrolet Detroit Belle Isle Grand Prix presented by Lear. And I'm joined by Trans Am driver Jeff Hinkle. Jeff, talk about your team and a little bit about yourself and why did you decide to come to Trans Am Racing?
Sure. We've been running SCCA racing in the amateur leagues for about 8 years. Did very well there. Wanted the next level of competition. So this is our first pro year. The team is based in Daytona Beach, Florida. And I live in Destin, Florida. It's been a great experience so far, and it's definitely a world-class group of guys out here to run with, take the game up a level, and we've been having a lot of fun. We were really looking forward to this weekend as well. Unfortunately, we have a short end to our weekend, but it happens from time to time, so it's all good.
What made you decide to go to Trans Am Racing?
I always love a challenge. When I plateau out and I'm not really getting challenged anymore, it gets boring for me and I lose interest. So this was a great opportunity for me to step up to the next level and run against some great guys, take my game up. So
yeah. All right, this is one of the drivers right here. Obviously bummed about not racing this weekend. This is Casey Campbell with G1NBC Sports.
Thanks.
This is Casey Campbell with G1NBC Sports. We're here at the Chevrolet Detroit Belle Isle Grand Prix presented by Lear and now joined by Trans Am driver Tommy Dreese, who drives the War of the Planet of the Apes car in the TA2 class. Tommy, of course, this is not your first time coming here, and what's it like racing in Trans Am in Detroit?
Oh, you know, it just brings back great memories. We've had some really fast cars here. I love street courses. That's where I started my racing, is in the Hollywood Hills on the street, you know. And so just something special and something natural for me to come on the street course.
How do you like your chances in Detroit this weekend?
Really good. We're on the pole. We're not on the pole, but we're P1 this morning. So, but you know, I don't know how good of a run some people got. So I was able to get a little clear track. It's real dusty still. And, you know, just looking forward to a really tough street fight.
You look at the series in Trans Am. What's it like to have Trans Am back? Because now it's a points championship race, but last year was an exhibition race.
Well, that means people are going to drive harder. They're going to take a little more chances. I actually was here in the IMSA race last year. I'm actually also racing in the prototype PC class of IMSA. In fact, I have to leave in a couple minutes to get in the car there. But, you know, I watched the Trans Am race here, and I saw they were a little careful, and then I found out it wasn't a points race, you know, so I think people are going to put a little bit more on the line and go faster.
All right, Tommy, good luck this weekend and good luck in in the WeatherTech series, and look out for Tommy Dreese in Trans Am. This is Casey Campbell with G1 NBC Sports.
All right, thank you very much.
How is the track out there today?
The track's fabulous. The organizers did a great job of smoothing the place out, like they said they would. In our cars, we don't feel it as much as a TA car or the Indy cars or the sports cars from IMSA, if you will. We have a little bit more travel. I don't think the stadium super trucks feel the bumps at all. I think they're wondering what they were smoothing out. But nonetheless, the track was fantastic. Really excited. It feels faster than last year. It feels like they opened up some corners, and maybe our cars just got faster. These Pirelli tires might just be getting us around that much better.
How are you guys doing this season so far in Trans Am?
We've had a rough start to the year. Our year personally has been really rough from the get-go. We had engine troubles first two races of the season, and then we were a victim of circumstances in turn one at Road Atlanta on the last lap on the last event. So that stuff happens. This is racing. You know, that's why we show up every weekend. It's not easy, and those challenges is what make it very rewarding in the end when you get to celebrate with your group. You know, to us right now, being at the top of a practice sheet, that's a good little victory for us and this team. It's a good boost of morale and makes us feel like we've been on the right path the whole time.
All right, Adam, good luck out there today. Good luck on there on Sunday. He'll be racing on Sunday in the TA2 race, so watch out for Adam Andretti. This is Casey Campbell with G1 NBC Sports.
Thanks, Casey.
Thank you, Adam. Hey, it's Casey from the Grand Prix. We got some, we're in the Trans Am garage. Now all the cars are here and all the drivers are here. This is all exciting, and Trans Am is the support series for the other series that are racing here today. But this is a great series in the Trans Am series. Well, look at all these cars. You got the TA2 cars. You got the TA cars. Got some drivers down here. Let's go down here. Here we have the 74 car. That's Gar Robinson and the Robinson in there. And right here is Shane Lewis. And there's Gar right there. And all right, we're back here at the Chevrolet Detroit Belle Isle Grand Prix, and now I'm joined by Gar Robinson, who drives the 74 in the TA2 class. Gar, welcome back to Detroit, and how have you guys done this season?
We're just happy to be here, Detroit again. We had a blast last year. This year is going really well for us. I only have one race that I haven't podiumed at. The whole team has podiumed every race so far, so that's we're working really good on our end. But we got good morale at the shop, and it's just good to be back in Detroit, where the shop's based and everything. So we're really excited for today, and I think it's going to be a good show this weekend.
How do you like your chances tomorrow on Sunday?
I think our chances are good. Definitely being here before helped us out a lot. I think it would be pretty hard because we don't really have too much track time here or too much practice time this weekend. I think it'll be a little hard for everyone else to get up to speed, but it'll definitely separate the drivers from the non, I think. So
talk about Detroit a little bit, and obviously the track. What was it like out there today?
I love this place, man. It's the track is bumpy, which is really great because you can sort of time where you can go back to throttle or go back to brake by the seat of your pants, honestly. I think after you come out of the carousel, there's a nice bump that's still there, thank God, but it definitely tells you when to go back to full power.
Adam Andretti stepping in there. How about that?
Yeah, we have a great time off on and off the track. We're hoping that me and him can put on a good show for the fans this year again. I remember last year we went through turn five, and it started raining right on turn five, and we went through it with just opposite lock, and we heard the whole crowd stand up and cheer for us. It was really cool. So we're going to put on a good show this weekend, and we're excited to be here.
All right, thanks, Gar. Watch out for Gar Robinson. He's in the 74 car this weekend. You can't miss it. The blue and orange right there. This is Casey Campbell with G1 NBC Sports. This is Casey Campbell with G1 NBC Sports. We're down here at the Trans Am garage area. Now I'm here with Rafael Matos in this 87 car driving for Doug Peterson. How was the track out there today?
It was a little dirty, this as we expected in the first session. It's uh, the traditional street course, you know, a lot of bumps, off camber corners, and lots of places to hit the wall. So we're a little conservative in the first session. It's my first time here, so I'm just trying to learn the track as quick as I can.
What's it like to learn Detroit? It's obviously a tough course to learn. What's so difficult about it?
Well, first of all, it's a concrete type of a street course, so it's very low grip. So, and on the top of that, we have a lot of bumps. So it's really difficult. Basically, I try to train a little bit on the simulator, so I'm more up to speed when I come here. So, you know, it's been pretty smooth so far.
Coming into this Trans Am series, this is one of the only street courses you race on. What's the difference between the normal road courses you guys race on than the street course here at Detroit?
Well, first, the level grip, it's much lower. Obviously, we have bumps all over the place and walls are surrounding us the whole time, so it's really tricky to learn. Some of the corners are blind, so I try to use my previous experience in IndyCars to learn the track and learn as quick as I can. We only have two 30-minute sessions and we're qualifying, so I think it was a good first session.
All right, this is Rafael Matos. He's driving the number 87 car for Doug Peterson. Watch out for him. He'll be in the TA2 race on Sunday. And this is Casey Campbell with G1 NBC Sports. Look who we ran into while we were down in the Trans Am garage. If you guys are a NASCAR fan, then this face would be familiar to you on TV. Wally Dallenbach Jr. is also the chief steward of Trans Am. You may know him on NASCAR Race Hub on Fox Sports 1. Wally, what is your job here during the Trans Am race week?
Well, my job is I'm basically the guy that hands out the penalties during the weekend. The chief steward's job is really the head official. So I, you know, kind of observe the race. If anybody breaks the law, so to speak, I'm the guy that's got to drop the hammer down on them.
Now, you were a driver for a long, long time, but Trans Am is where you had your most success. Just talk about the Trans Am series for a little bit in your career.
The Trans Am series has been very special to me because it did. It put me on the map. First year I started in Trans Am, it was our own team. It was my sister and my sister's boyfriend, and we went to all the races, and I got noticed, and right after that got a factory ride. And was fortunate enough to win a couple of championships. So, love the format of the racing. It's all out, no pit stops. It's really good hard racing with the muscle cars. I mean, it's just one of my favorite forms of racing.
The Motor City 100 is obviously one of the big Trans Am races on the schedule. What's it like to have Trans Am back in Detroit for a points race now this year for the first time in a while?
I think it's really important. I mean, I know when we came as a driver, this was the race to win. If you could win the Trans Am race in Detroit, you're doing it in front of all the factories. And back when I was driving, there was a lot of factory involvement in the series. So this is a special event. It's great to see Trans Am back here at Detroit. They belong here, and they put on a great show.
All right. This is Chief Steward Wally Dallenbach Jr. You can he'll be handing out, watching the race very closely to see if any drivers misbehave on the racetrack. This is Casey Campbell with G1 NBC Sports. Thanks, Wally.
All right, guys.
This is Casey Campbell with G1 NBC Sports. We're down here in the Trans Am garage, a tour of the cars, and now we're here with Trans Am driver Claudio Burton. Claudio, what was it like out on the track today?
Well, the track's green, as everybody would expect. So just trying to rubber it up a little bit. And we went out on old tires, so really not looking for a lap time at this point, just rather getting the car set up properly.
What's it take to get a car set up for a street course like Detroit?
Well, the most important thing is just to be careful those first sessions out. You know, the track's very slippery and the cars aren't at temperature, and it's just, you cannot make a single mistake here. You'll just be in the fence.
Yeah, what's it not take to make a, what's, do you think is the toughest part about this course right here?
Well, the toughest part is the, you know, it's very bumpy. So, you know, to get the shock settings primarily correct is the most difficult thing, is to get it to go over those bumps and feel comfortable going over them.
All right. What's it like racing in the Trans Am series? Of course, you've been to Detroit so many times. This is a points race for the first time in a very long time. How big is this for Trans Am?
Well, racing in Detroit is always huge. You know, it's what made America great in a lot of ways. It's you know, our auto center capital of the country, and it's always a great opportunity to race here.
All right, Claudio Burton will be racing on Saturday in the TA race. He'll be driving the number 7 car. This is Casey Campbell with G1 NBC Sports. This is Casey Campbell. We're down here at the Trans Am garage area, and I'm here with two-time defending TA champion Amy Ruman. Amy, what's it like to be back in Detroit?
It's amazing. I love this place. I love this track. I love street racing. The fans here are awesome. They come out and support us. There's nothing like being in Motown for the Motor City 100 by three-dimensional. So, I mean, we're so excited to be back here. And we had a good run this morning, so that's good.
Well, you led into my next question. How did you think the track was out there today?
Well, I mean, we were on at 7:45. It's not that great. So we didn't see a lot of tire temperatures yet. We'll look for speeds and better times this afternoon, clearly, when the track warms up and we're able to get some heat in the tires. But it was just a shakedown this morning, so, you know, we'll be all right.
For the first time in a long time, you get to gain championship points here at Detroit. How big of a deal is that in the Motor City 100?
It's a huge deal. You know, last year was an invitational race, so we brought the backup car because we had a race the following weekend in New Jersey. So I'm glad to have our current car here at C7 Corvette. So we'll look to place a lot better than we did last year and try to get some valuable championship points. It will be definitely worth trying to get on the podium here. And you know, it's coveted, so I would love to be on the Detroit podium.
Do you think drivers are going to take a lot more risks now that it's a championship race?
I mean, we take a lot of risks just coming here, you know, with these walls, but, you know, it's a little tight. But, yeah, I think you'll see a lot of action toward the end of the race. I think everybody will behave themselves until probably the last 5 laps, then it'll be on.
All right. She's going to be driving the number 23 Corvette in the TA race on Saturday. Amy Ruman, the two-time defending Trans Am champion in the TA class. This is Casey Campbell from G1 NBC Sports. This is Casey Campbell. We're down here at the Trans Am Racing Garage, and I'm here with Trans Am driver Jordan Bernlohr. Jordan, you were down here just on the track for practice. How'd you think the car went for you?
The car was pretty good. We got just some little changes we might need to make, just get some more seat time in the car. Definitely my first few laps at Detroit. It's a little bumpy, but it's definitely fun. The walls come at you fast, so we're gonna have to be smooth and just try and make no mistakes for the race.
What do you think the toughest part about this course is?
I definitely say the concrete. I mean, the fact that you're surrounded by barriers, so I mean, you make a mistake and you're going in the wall and it's not gonna be pretty.
Now, you've done some other stuff before the race here. You've you were at Children's Hospital yesterday. You were in the Doug Guthrie kart racing out at Kart to Kart in Sterling Heights. How's your week been for you this week?
Oh, this week for me has been great. I mean, to get all the media coverage has been super fun, to interact at Kart to Kart, to hang out with all the professional drivers, to win the race. That wasn't too bad. And then going to the Children's Hospital for Racing for Kids, that was huge. That was a really big deal to me. I felt really good, really privileged that I could try and help and get these kids that are staying in the hospital to see something different, see some racing, and put a smile on their face, which was a big deal to me.
All right, Jordan, what made you get into racing at your age?
Well, for sure, I mean, right from the start, I've literally loved racing. My dad, my whole family, we're all a racing family. I grew up with an indoor go-kart track in Burnsville, Minnesota, called Pro Kart Indoors, and started at 3 years old. And I've literally, I mean, Michael Schumacher, Ayrton Senna, all these racers, these Formula One drivers, IndyCar drivers, I looked up to them. They're my heroes, and I want to become it.
All right. See Jordan on the track. He'll be in the 77 car right here. He'll be in the TA2 race on Sunday. This is Casey Campbell with G1 NBC Sports.
Thank you.
Thanks, Jordan.
Yeah, thanks, sir.
This is Casey Campbell with G1 NBC Sports. We're back down here at the Trans Am Garage. Now I'm joined by the president of Trans Am Racing Company, John Claggett. John, give us an update on Trans Am.
Well, back in Detroit for second year. Love it here. It's the Motor City. Our cars are meant for Motor City Mustangs, Camaros, Challengers, so we're having a good time. Great weather today.
What do you think about this race is now a points race this year for the first time in a very long time. What's it like as being as the Motor City 100 as part of your championship run?
Well, it was always a goal in 2011 when we created the Trans Am Race Company. Getting back to Detroit was goal number one. So we accomplished that last year as an invitational. And now with this being a points race, of course, now we've really gotten it back to the status that it deserves to be.
Talk about some of the star drivers in this. There's two races, TA race on Saturday, TA2 race on Sunday. Talk about some of the guys starting with TA and followed by TA2.
Well, both have their individual slots. Ernie Francis Jr. is kind of the newcomer in the Trans Am category. He's won the last two races. He was the Trans Am 4-class champion the last couple of years. Very talented young driver, has a great future in motorsport, and he's very quick. So you'll see Ernie Francis Jr. taking on Amy Ruman and Tommy Dreese. That should be a great race for the win. In the TA2, very unique in that a lot of star power there. We have guys like Rolf Matos, who's making his debut in the series this weekend, very quick, open wheel racers, won championships, and Kyle Marcelli, who's won a lot of races in GT sports car racing, and they're joining the regular cast of characters like an Adam Andretti, Gar Robinson, Shane Lewis. Last year's race as an invitational was spectacular, and now as a points race, I think it should be phenomenal.
All right, lots to look forward to in Trans Am this year. John, of course, will be leading the charge of Trans Am into the future. And this is Casey Campbell with G1 NBC Sports. All right, we've had a great time down here. We got to interview some drivers down here in the TA and TA2 class of Trans Am. Trans Am is obviously a series that was popular back in the day. Now it's coming back with obviously the return of the Motor City 100. And for the first time in a long time, this is going to be a championship points race. So drivers, are going to take a lot more risk. Drivers are going to be a lot more forgiving on those moves right there. And of course, Pirelli is also a big sponsor. The Trans Am series brought to you by Pirelli. A lot of the tires down there, Pirelli's the soft tire compound. So obviously this is the America Road Racing Series. This is obviously a great series to go to, obviously a support series, but this is going to be a fun series, a fun race. Saturday will be on at 8:45, and then the TA2 race will be on Sunday. As watch out for Trans Am and going down on the track, and obviously we'll be on a little bit later on the network, so stay tuned for that. This is Casey Campbell from G1 NBC from the Trans Am Racing Garage.